Dear friends, welcome to my Mission for Holistic Development, a threadbare discussion series. Love begets love, hatred begets hatred. Our planet is full of diversities, but we also know that we are born of the same cosmic intelligence. In this vast garden of cosmic intelligence, there are varieties of flowers. All the flowers have their own beauty, their own appeal. I love rose. It doesn't mean that I should destroy jasmine or marigold or other flowers. It is true that some are born to love and some are born to kill. Lord Buddha in his childhood, as Siddhartha, had saved the goose shot by Devadatta, his cousin. Devadatta was happy to hunt the goose. The wounded goose had fallen into the lap of Siddhartha. He had taken the arrow out from the body of the hapless bird and nursed the wound. Political poisoning of the vulnerable minds is creating more hunters than saviors nowadays. There is no King Suddhodana around to give the verdict that it is the saviors who deserve love and respect, or the saviors is always, savior is always greater than the hunter. Political leaders who mislead you more than lead you never fight in spite of their differences, but their followers are ready to fight and kill one another at the slightest provocation. Dalai Lama, His Holiness, propagates Buddhism, but have you ever heard him abusing Rama or Krishna or other gods and deities of Sanatana Dharma? Lord Vivekananda is known to have overwhelmed all the scholars of all other religions in Chicago Dharma Sammelan in 1893 while dwelling upon the salient features of our Sanatana Dharma, like compassion for all the creatures, non-aggression, quest for the ultimate realization, and tolerance of other religions. It is worthwhile to quote an incident from the life of our noble missile man, Abdul Kalam sir, a little downhearted after his not being selected for flying the aircraft he had visited Swami Sivanand in the Himalayas for a spiritual guidance. Not only he got the answer there, but also he became his devout follower. Just a few years ago, this scholar saint of the Sanatana Dharma was at the fag end of his life. Abdul Kalam sir had visited him again and offered him his book, sitting like a child near Swamiji. Humility of this great scientist and his love for the lighthouse of Sanatana Dharma, Sanatana Truth, brought tears to my eyes. APJ Abdul Kalam and his devout father had profound respect for the head priest of the Rameswaram temple, Pakshi Lakshmana Shastri, and the head priest also reciprocated the same love and the same respect towards Abdul Kalam and his father. But the stories of Abdul Kalam will make you a lover of humanity. So the merchants of hatred do not spread such stories, nor the peddlers of animosity, peddlers of ill will, spread the stories of Sant Kabir, Samarth Ram Das, Lord Ramakrishna, Swami Vivekananda, Radha Ram Mohan Rai, Swami Dayananda, Ramana Maharshi, Acharyas and His Holiness Sri Ram Sharma, even Ramya Rola and Max Muller, the great scholars of the West. We are great admirers of the eternal truth ingrained in our religion. But nowadays, all these great people who made immense human contribution to restore the glory of our nation are being deliberately pushed into oblivion. If you find that some evil is there in your religion, do something positive to remove it. Don't make the evil a pretext to abuse your religion as it has become a fashion nowadays. Raja Ram Mohan Rai took a vow to eradicate Sati Pratha when he found how his own Bhabhi was forcibly burnt on the pyre of her husband. He took help of William Bentinck and wiped the evil of Sati out in 1929. A good number of evils have been eradicated, but some still exist. Sanatan is the religion which is open to discussion and open to reform. If you are ready to reform, nobody goes for hunting your head. Rather, you are treated with respect. But if you are cursing Sanatan every now and then because of your shallow understanding, you should learn a lesson from Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Baba Saheb did not abuse his fellow counterparts or the gurus of the Sanatan Dharma. Although his disillusionment with Hindu Dharma was complete, he chose to embrace Buddhism. Baba Saheb did not abuse Rama or Krishna or Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh or other gods and deities. Baba Saheb was a man of grace. He was a Rivellian. He was a noble scholar. But the irony is that some of his followers, not all, are abusing Sanatan Dharma and spouting venom and spreading animosity, drawing sustenance from the same evil and cursing it also at the same time is the height of double standard morality. The alpha and omega of what I mean to say is, if you are ready to live in harmony, look for similarities. But if you are bent upon fighting, there is no dearth of pretexts. You may fight in the name of caste, creed, religion, race, and even in the name of color of your skin. Motto of our Sanatana is Atma Vatsarva Bhutesu Yah Pasyati Sa Panditah. So learn from the honeybees, from near and far, collect the pollen from different flowers and make the ambrosia of sweetness and strength. Thank you.